بسم الله والابن والروح القدس الواحد امين. تحل علينا نعمته وبركته من الان والى الابد امين.
Good morning. Happy feast of the apostles. Tomorrow is the feast, so but I think it was so kind to pray all the prayers of the feast of tomorrow, so for those who cannot attend. So it's a great blessing. It's a great blessing for me to be among you here. It's a beautiful church, and it's a blessing of Abuna Antonius and Abuna Joseph. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to talk in their presence. So that is a great humbleness from their side. First of all, when we talk about today's gospel, it is very rich. And I am the least to talk about this gospel today. But may God give me the word. And there is a rule that we should agree upon, that whatever you receive or the word doesn't really have anything to do with the speaker. It has to do with the recipient, with the listener. So the power of the word depends on the readiness of the listener, not the one who speaks, because the word is powerful. So the word itself is powerful. So, and because we are in the Bay Area, so let me start with some funny question. So I know that here it's the latest fashion, that's high tech, everything. And I'm a Sunday school teacher, so I don't say sermons. I just give a Sunday school lesson. So, but if we talk about brands, so I'm going to ask you something. So not about the apostles, so that's, you can relax, about brands. So if we say, like, McDonald's, what McDonald's slogan? Do you remember? Anyone? Huh? I'm loving it. Right? Yeah, okay. So what is Nike? Huh? What's the slogan of Nike? Huh? Yeah. What is the slogan? Huh? What's the slogan? What is written behind Nike? Just do it. Very good. So, yeah, very good. So just do it. So we go harder. How about McDonald's? No, McDonald's, we said it. How about Apple? Who works in telecom or in phones? Huh? How about Apple? Huh? What's the slogan of Apple? Think different. Think different. Anyway, it is an introduction for a question. What do you think if we call Christians? If we say Christians? Brand the Christians. What name would you give it to Christians? Love, everyone, okay? Kindness. I love it, man. That's a good one.
Also, joy.
Joy.
Honesty.
Honesty. That's an amazing. You can come and say the sermon for today. How about that? this humbleness. Great. Thank you. Thank you. But can we link it to the reading of today? So if we remember the reading of today, and I'm going to just repeat one or two verses. It says that the harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. What does it mean? If we can conclude this in just one word, what can we say? Service. Thank you. Thank you. Service. We are called the Christians means that we are servants. And we serve who? God, the Lord. And I can give you some evidence, very, very quick evidence about it. Because we are called the Christians. First time we have been called the Christians, do you remember where? Was in Acts, right? It's in Acts 11. And I'm going to read to you very quickly in Acts 11. It says Acts 11, 26. That is the first time ever we hear the word Christian. And we have been called the Christian after what happened. So I will tell you. So it says, so it was that for a whole year they assembled with the church and taught a great many people. And the apostles were first called Christians in Antioch. So what happened first? They taught many people. So what does it mean? People. So they reflected the image of Christ and taught people about Christ. Then people got converted to Christianity, and then we are called the Christian. So the first thing is that we cannot be Christians without serving. We cannot. That is the sequence. We cannot be called the Christians without serving. So, and that is the first thing. And if we can find like 100 proofs and evidences in the texture saying about how great is the service, and that is the foundation to be Christians, that we should go and serve. So if we read, so 3 weeks ago we had the Pentecost feast, before we fasted, before we started the apostles' fasting period, and it was a powerful, very powerful like verse as well. It says, "But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witness to me in Jerusalem and in Judea and in Samaria and then the end of the earth." So we are, it is a commandment that we should witness to our Lord. Otherwise, we are useless. If we do not reflect in our deeds the Christ who dwells inside us, so it is kind of useless. So, and even in St. John, and if you know the word, if you know the verse, كلنا عارفينها, جئت لأخدم ولا لأخدم؟ لأخدم, جئت لأخدم لا لأخدم. وقال برضو حيثما أكون أنا يكون خدمي. يعني when I go and serve, it is not me. I'm serving, he is serving, and I am just with him. He is the one that he does the service, and I am just with him. So it says, let him follow me. If anyone serve me, let him follow me, and where I am, there my servant will be also. If anyone serves me, my Father will honor him. Can you imagine the great honor that we can get if we serve him, if we serve with him? He is the main source of the service. No one can serve by his own. It is the word, it is God himself. He is serving, but you just take the blessing of the service. You just take the blessing of the service. And the verse that we just been through, that the harvest is truly great, there is a lot of myth, false ideas. Some people interpret this verse as like, this is for the high rank in the church. We are talking about deacons or full-time deacons, priesthood or something. That is a false idea. That is truly false idea. Why? Because in the same chapter, in Luke 10, that is a very famous chapter talking about who? Do you remember? In the end of this chapter, he talks about the Good Samaritan. He talks about the Good Samaritan. What did the Good Samaritan do? Was the Good Samaritan priest? Was he from the Levite? No. This man who fell down and he was wounded and he was like coming from Jerusalem. So he was like left like dead. And the Levite and the priest passed by him and they didn't help him. Who helped him? The Samaritan man. The Samaritan man. It says that what he did, he went to him with great passion and love. He showed him the passion and love. Sometimes we get like confused. What type of service should I do? I don't have time. I don't really, I cannot dedicate, I cannot commit myself to a service. But this guy just passed by with great love. He just showed the love of God that dwells inside him towards this guy. So he went by him and he bandaged his wounds. How many people are wounded around us? Feelings, emotionally, psychologically. How many? We all are sick, to be very honest. We all need help. We all need this kind of support, this kind of passion, this kind of love, someone to comfort us. That is a service. That is a service. And he said, he poured him on him oil and wine. He poured on him oil and wine. He brought him to church. So we are here to present God and to attract people. So we are not evangelists like what God seeks from us. We need to attract people to church. We need to just go and don't feel shy to present our Lord and to say, yes, we are Christians. So he sent him to an inn, and that is what is in St. Luke. So Samaritan man, when he bandaged this guy and he supported him, he sent to him to the inn. He sent to him to the church, to the bosom of the church. And he paid for him and he promised him to come back and to visit him. Sometimes we go and help someone and yeah, finally it's gone, I'm done. No, that is not the service that please God's heart. So the service that it comes from the heart, that you really not just doing a task or fulfilling a task, I served, I did something, or I did this and that. No, it is something coming from the heart. And that is what makes us servants of the Lord, because we represent him. He never did something like in Hassel, كده. يعني هو عاد يجري وعمال يعمل معجزات. No, he was looking at every single person as a beloved one. And that is exactly what he wanted us to do. I will tell you a true story I heard from our loved father, Dawood Lam'i. And this happened in like 10 years ago in Ghana. In Ghana, there is a Coptic church in there. And there was a lady passing by the church. And during this time, there was a summer camp for the kids. And the kids from all over the city or the town gather together and they pray and they do some activities like the same what we do here. And this lady passed by, and then her car was like fell down or something happened. Something wrong happened with this car, so it broke down. And then she was seeking help, and she found like many hands around her supporting her. Who were they? The kids. The kids went out and supported her. Someone brought her water. Someone brought her some food. And they brought their servants in order to see if they can help this lady. And they helped this lady. And she was like very happy of this kind of care that she found. Later on, she started to ask about the church. 2 months later, she got baptized. And her name now in this city is called Joyce, the Samaritan Joyce. What did she do? She went back to her town. And she preached the word of the kids. What the kids did with her. What the people in this church did with her. And now, all the town in Ghana are Coptic Orthodox. And I can tell you the name. You can look this name up. So, the name of this town, because it's very difficult for me, it is Ushi. O-S-H-I-E-Y-E-H. It is... So the entire town now converted to Christianity because of what? Someone gave her a sermon? Someone tried to convince her to convert from her religion? No, because she has seen the love. She has seen the love. So if we act like the Samaritan, the Good Samaritan in Luke 10, we can like create many and many and many of the Samaritan women that can go and to preach the Lord. So, and in the reading today, if you remember, what happened when the apostles came back to the Lord? He rejoiced. He was happy. Can you imagine that your service will make our Lord happy? Can you imagine that he told him, if you listen carefully to Abuna in the gospel, he said that he has seen Satan falling down like lightning from the heaven. Can you imagine that you are making victorious like win for our Lord when you serve? Because you make Satan fall down, and we all want to Satan to fall down. We don't want to see him, right? So, service in a conclusion. Service is a commandment. It is not a choice. It is a commandment. Without serving, we cannot be with him, because he said, if I am there, so my servant will be there. So we cannot be there unless we are servant. Serving is a love. Just shows a love. Don't think about what to do. Just show your love to others around you, in your community, in your school, in your work. Just show this love. Don't be shy to say that you are Christian, of course. And serving is a mission of the church. We are here in a missionary church. It is not like missionary, like American church. Everyone talks American and speaks American. No. We are in a mission. We are in a mission to change all the community around us and to attract them to our Lord Jesus Christ. And service, as I told you, make our Lord happy, and service makes Satan's kingdom fall down. That is the joy that we can get out of our service. So may our Lord make us worthy to serve His name and to be His soldiers and His servants on earth. And the glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.